Well, labs across the country don't have enough COVID-19 testing kits to meet demand. Now they're facing supply shortages for other tests we rely on. If the demand isn't met, health experts tell Amanda Brandeis, more patients could be turned away.
The pandemic ignited a global fight against a fast-moving and deadly virus.
In the beginning of the pandemic, a lot of manufacturers shifted gears and started doing more COVID manufacturing,
ramping up testing and diverting supplies to combat the virus. But in the months ahead, laboratories started facing another threat.
It was a bit of a surprise how overwhelming it was throughout the country and that there weren't just hot spots. And it really indicated that this was a major national issue.
Clinical lab director Melissa Miller says they're facing supply shortages for COVID-19 tests and many others.
Probably the biggest one was for sexually transmitted infections. So chlamydia, gonorrhea being the most common ones that we diagnose in the lab.
Ramping up COVID testing has caused a shortage in materials needed for these other tests.
It's a guessing game. Many times we don't know when our next shipment is coming of some of the items we're short on.
These testing shortages are now being tracked with a new data collection tool. The American Society for Microbiology has surveyed over 130 labs since September.
The first week of the survey, almost 90% of laboratories that responded reported a shortage for tests for STIs.
Dr. Miller says that figure is still too high today, around 50%.
It's another public health travesty.
And 47% of labs need more testing supplies for routine bacteria, like strep throat, urinary tract infections, and pneumonia.
Since June, I have been worried about this exact moment. You have the COVID surge, the upcoming holidays, and the winter season, and you have respiratory season.
Now they're looking to survey more labs.
Data is power, right? We need the data that this is a problem, and getting some federal action on this, I think, is critical, right?
And she says the longer labs wait for critical supplies, the more Americans will suffer the consequences. I'm Amanda Brandeis reporting.